Hello there and welcome. Thank you for joining us. It's a Friday once again and we brought you the Business Roundup where we cover stories happening in the world of business, or should we call it the economic outlook for this particular episode. My name is Viola Kusasira and this time we are joined by Moses Mulondo, a business journalist and editor with The New Vision. He's already here. Let's dive in. Thank you, Moses, for joining us. Let's start off with the new financial year that we are just setting our first foot in. What are some of those areas that you think Uganda would perform well when we invest in this as a country?
Okay, first of all, the budget for the new financial year is actually one of the best budgets that we have had over the years, because it has put a lot of resources in the sectors of the economy that drive economic growth. For example, there is money that has been put in the budget of $200 million for supporting value addition on the exports that we are taking to different nations of the world. So the people who are involved in the entire value chain of dealing in exports, they can make use of that money. There is also $85 billion that has been allocated to UDB, Uganda Development Bank. And Uganda Development Bank is a national development bank that actually gives the lowest, the cheapest credit facility for the business communities at a very low interest rate of 12% for those who are in Greater Kampala and 10% for those who are in rural areas. So those who are planning to start investments, they can apply to UDB and make use of that money. In the course of this week, we interviewed the Secretary to the Treasury as New Vision, and Ramadan Gowi, and he said they have actually earmarked close to 2.7 trillion for wealth creation in the budget for the new financial year that has just started. Of course, that also includes more than 1 trillion that has been allocated to PDM, Polish Development Model. This country, the leading export earner is gold. In the last 3 months, actually, gold exports resumed, and now we are earning much more than we were earning before. On average, per month, more than $200 million, which is a lot of money, much higher than the second leading export earner, which is coffee. That is also, of course, the earnings from coffee have also exponentially increased. In the last financial year, we earned about $800 million. A year before, it was $400 million. So our earnings from coffee actually have almost doubled.
And part of the budget that was recently read out for the nation, there was money that was allocated for wealth creation. And so it gets me thinking, what are some of the ways that you think that money can be best used by Ugandan to be able to, you know, not be left out, if especially involved in business? What are some of the best ways a Ugandan can make sure to partake in the wealth creation money?
I agree with you. Yes, tourism is one other area where Ugandans can make a lot of investments, but also the construction industry. In this new budget that has just started in the new financial year, the works and transport sector got the biggest portion of the national budget of about 8 trillion.
All right, thank you, Moses, for explain to Ugandans that are watching right now how they can make sure to dip their hand within the money basket that has been given out to the wealth creation. Let's now talk about the oil and gas sector. It's been silent for a while, especially here in the Business Roundup. What's the newest? What's happening? And also, I have heard there is increased investment as we speak, so please take us through.
The activities in the oil sector have increased, and recently Total Energies erected rigs at Itilenga. These are drilling equipment for drilling the hole that will be used to scoop oil from the ground. A similar exercise was done at Kingfisher by the Chinese company there. So a lot of progress has been done, and it is estimated that between $15 billion and $20 billion will be invested in the oil sector in the next 5 years. So thousands, millions of opportunities will be created in the country, in the oil sector. And it is estimated, when we were talking to the Secretary to the Treasury in the course of this week, he told us that Uganda will earn, these will be the profits actually, excluding the investments by the oil company, close to $40 billion in the next 20 years, which is more than close to 150 trillion. It's a lot of money. So we are very optimistic that that money will greatly turn around our economy, because already, by the way, we are about to be announced a middle income.
Thank you so much for having made time to be part of the interview today. And if you're watching, thank you too for always joining us on Fridays to catch the business roundup. This is what we were trying to bring to you, a picture of what the economy will be looking like in this financial year. But also you can look for areas for investment using the information that Moses has given to us. Until next time, back to the news.